States Air Force, the United States Navy, and the United States Marine Corps as well, and other countries around the world too. It has a jet engine that turns a propeller. It's called a turboprop engine. It's got an 1,100 horsepower driving Whitney engine and advanced systems on board that will prepare pilots as they work on earning their wings for the most advanced aircraft in the Air Force inventory, including planes like the F-22 Raptor that we'll see later today. Flying the T-6 Texan II today from Columbus Air Force Base in Mississippi are Tom Crenslow. He's in the front seat. He's from Kansas City, Missouri. And in the back seat, Will Carroll from Richmond, Virginia. This aircraft is fully aerobatic, can reach top speeds of over 350 miles per hour, and has been since it won competition back in 1995 for what was known then as the Joint Primary Air Training System.
What?
Competing against manufacturers of
airplanes
by Cisco Command. The T-6 Texan II carries that name of the North American Texan from World War II that trained tens of thousands of pilots to fly and which they earned their wings. Very few airplanes have had their names passed down to another generation of aircraft, but as you look at the maneuverability of the T-6 Texan II, it is a joy to watch, and it's a joy to fly.
Yeah.
It's hard to find the Aquafina. They've started making them a little funky now, and it's got like half of a, it's about half this size, and they, like, when you twist them off, it messes up and they won't go back on right. It just sits there loose. Just, they just started making them cheaper.
There are over a thousand of these airplanes that are serving our United States military. It can operate from a -3.5 G's to a +7 times the force of gravity. Now we stand here on Earth with 1 G, a 200 pound guy, 1 G, 200 pounds. 2 G's, that's 400 pounds. 3 G's, 600 pounds. 4 G's, this airplane is stressed for 7 times the force of gravity, which means a 200-pound guy at 7 G's would weigh nearly 3/4 of a ton. Now, the pilots of these aircraft wear special suits. They are known as G-suits. And what they do is squeeze the medium speed G's, and they're put on to keep the legs, they'll fill up with air to squeeze the legs and the torso to keep the blood in the upper part of the body so the pilot won't pass out when pulling significant numbers of G's. This is going to be important as we talk to, as we watch Kevin Coleman fly later, because he will be experiencing some really heavy G forces. But there's the Texan II. Exceptionally responsive, and yet very, very dependable and easy to maintain. And there's the salute, the wing wag salute. And as they pitch up and gain altitude, they are finished.